everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'll be making a card using a new stamp set by The Ali Wei Stamps, which is called In Stitches. I'll be using this mini deck paper pad by Cosmo Cricket. It's an old paper pad that I had in my stash forever, and these are just two pieces of scrap paper. I'm using brown ink to stamp a tomato pin cushion, and I'm going to paper piece this cute tomato. So I'm stamping on the green and on the red paper. Now I'm using my scissors to cut all around the tomato. I'm being very careful and I cut just outside the lines. I get a lot of questions about how I cut everything out. Now the red part of the tomato is easy, but the green one is a bit more tricky. So what's how I do it? I never move my scissors, I just move the paper. Paper piecing is one of my favorite techniques, and I must admit that I like it more than coloring. And while I cut this around, just to remind you that all the supplies are listed just below the video on YouTube. You just have to click show more, and also below the video on my blog. Now I've used my tape runner and my pin cushion tomato is ready. So I'll be using some papers from this paper pad, and I've cut out two strips from this patterned paper. And now I'll use again my brown ink to stamp the needle. The needle is quite thick, so it's not so hard to cut around it. So I'm using again the same ink. Stamp it on craft paper, and now with my scissor I'll just go around very carefully. This stamp set I think is just adorable, and you can make lots of cards for all your friends that love sewing. And after cutting it very carefully, now my needle is ready. So now I'll go ahead and put everything together. What I'm doing here is using my tape runner to glue those strips of paper on top of my yellow patterned paper. The yellow patterned paper, I believe, goes perfectly with the theme of the card because it reminds you of vintage sewing patterns. Now I'm using my scissors to cut whatever sticks out. And now I'll go back to my tomato pin cushion, and I'll use my craft knife to cut a small little slit on the tomato. And also I use my craft knife to make a small hole on the needle. Now this doesn't have to be perfect, I'm just cutting out the small hole with the craft knife. And now here is the trick to make it look perfect. I'll just use a brown Copic marker and draw around the hole. Now I'll just put the needle through that little slit I cut out earlier, and secure it with some tape runner. And now that the pin cushion is ready, I'll just use foam squares to place it on top of the card. I'm using the same brown ink, and I'm going to stamp the sentiment, which is also included on the stamp set. And now for the fun part. I'm using this white embroider floss. I'll just cut out a small piece here and I'll thread it through the needle. I always like to add details on my cards that make them unique, and I think that this embroidery floss just really made this card today. And to stick the embroidery floss just where I want it to be, I'm using tacky glue. This is a fast drying glue pen. I got it a few days ago and I'm in love with it. I think you are going to see me using it a lot. So I just draw with this glue pen how I want the floss to be, and then I stick the floss on top of the glue line. Now, just to accent the card a bit more, I'm using the brown ink to stamp a zigzag stitch, which is not going to stay as is, actually. Now, here is the zigzag stitch, and now by using my piercing mat and the needle, I'm making some holes, and now I'm going to stitch through those holes using the same white embroidery floss. This is super easy and fun to do, you just follow the brown lines. And now that I finished with the stitching, I'm using some tape to secure the floss at the back. And finally, using my ATG gun, I'm going to secure this panel on top of my card base. I've used a craft cardstock as my card base, and this is a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. Here I'm just adding a small piece of foam square at the back of the tomato, and now everything looks perfect. And to finish off the card, I'm using my Wing of Stella glitter pen. This is the clear glitter pen, and that adds just a bit of shimmer on top of the pin cushion and on the needle. I'll cut some light here so you can see what I mean. And that's a card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired.